yourself anymore. I guess I'm just not interesting. I have no personality. I met a guy with cancer, and he felt sorry for me. I've never been a social guy. I'm always making children cry. I guess that's just the way it's meant to be. Help me make it out of bed, 'cause I am scared and sad. Help me make it through the day, 'cause there's nothing out there for me anymore. 'Cause I'm always coming in last place and getting dirt kicked in my face, and everyone pushes ahead of me and no one stops to care. And I curse the gods each day in vain for giving me this life of pain, when all I really need's a little hug. Help me make it through the night, 'cause I am tired and alone. I don't like myself.
Testing. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Checking the mic. Test. Asparagus. Help. Help. Asparagus. Falafel burger. Check. 1, 2. Alexa, what's the weather today?
Right now in Glendale, it's 88 degrees Fahrenheit with clear skies and sun. Throughout the day, you can expect more of the same, with a high of 95 degrees and a low of 68 degrees. By the way, there's an excessive heat warning in effect Monday, September 26, 10 a.m. to Wednesday, September 28, 8 p.m.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Henry's Kitchen, where today I'm going to be teaching you how to make Henry's delicious crepe. I want to thank Tibetsy for subscribing. Thanks, Tibetsy. A lot of people mispronounce today's dish as crepe. It's not a crepe. This is a French dish. The correct pronunciation, if you're trying to take it seriously, is crepe. This is the way they pronounce it in France and also in French Canada. and in parts of Louisiana. So let's get started. What could be more perfect for a special celebration than these beautiful strawberry crepes? Of course, you don't have to wait for an anniversary or birthday to enjoy crepe. There's easy to make and the whole family will love them. I will make crepe by the dozens, then let the kids fill them the way they like. Sometimes theirs don't look so pretty, but they still taste fantastic. For a brunch, baby shower, or other special occasions, you can have everything prepared ahead of time, then assemble them right before you're ready to serve. But they always make a beautiful presentation. So, there you have it. We're going to be making some wonderfully delicious crepe. I guess in France they don't pronounce the S at the end, so it's not, it doesn't sound like it's plural, but it is. I also want to say a special thank you to Brian Daniels and Raven at the Domain GPCE, because I don't know if you're able to tell from the beginning here, but we have a wonderful new well, there's supposed to be a chef's hat. Oh yeah, roast beef now has a chef's hat. And when I put him on, he doesn't keep it on for very long, but I was able to snap a nice picture. So thanks Brian and Raven. I did their podcast recently if you want to check it out, the Domain GPCE. Couple of questions here. Kai Rosa says, I could be wrong, but I think your painting is upside down again. No, I think it's correct this time. I bought that painting at the Goodwill, and I guess if you have it right side up, it looks like it's flowers coming out of the ground. Thanks, Larklin, for subscribing. But if you have it upside down, I guess it looks like stalactites or stalagmites, whichever one is the one that comes down. Hidewhite 2 says, I thank you for keeping the picture straight and not sophisticated. Yeah, I guess the sophisticated way would be to have it upside down and sort of abstract. Everyone type Forson says, can you turn the painting upside down, please? Change scares me. Yeah, I know what he's talking about. Or she.
Okay.
Or they, or whoever everyone type Forson is, but, I don't know a lot of times who it is individually, but I do want to say that this is something that we need to talk about. I started out Henry's Kitchen about 11 years ago in a kitchen in my bachelor apartment, which had red and yellow trimmings, and it was sort of a funky 1920s sort of style building, which if you live in a city and you see that you're going to be living in a funky building of any sort, it usually means that the plumbing doesn't work correctly and that when you flush the toilet, the waste comes out of the sink. And that's kind of the place that I was in. But I started Henry's Kitchen there, and I became very accustomed to that little kitchen. But then eventually I got kicked out, and so I had to find a different place to live. And change is difficult, I guess is what I'm saying. Hacklin says, I'm moving into a little shack this Saturday, so I don't have to live under the bridge anymore. My mom still doesn't talk to me because I watched your show, even though she told me not to. Can you talk to my mom and tell her you're not some creepy middle-aged man on the internet? Okay, so it sounds like Hacklin's dealing with some family issues. Fitchnall says, is Los Angeles expensive? Yeah, it is as a city, but I don't leave my home, and so that makes it easy for me to not spend money Okay, well, let's get into our dish today here. I'm going to start with some of our ingredients. What we have here is 3 eggs, some strawberries, some Philadelphia cream cheese. I am not sponsored by Philadelphia cream cheese, but that's the logo on there. So I apologize if the people at Philadelphia cream cheese don't want me using it, but maybe we can bleep it out afterward or something. Also, we've got some confectioner's sugar. Remember, confectioner's sugar is very different from granulated sugar. The confectioner is someone who makes candy as opposed to a granulator, who's just somebody who turns sugar into grains. And those two occupations don't get along at all, so don't put them in the same room. And then we've got our enriched white all-purpose bleached flour, which is very low in nutritional value but very high in filling. And we also have some salt. So that should be good for now. Let's take a look at what it is exactly that we're supposed to be doing here. Can you hear me okay, by the way? Check. Help. You can hear that fine. By the way, we have some nice song requests that I'm going to get to later today, and a fun game called Trombone Champ that we're going to play. It's a little like Guitar Hero, but it's you're playing trombone. What could be more perfect for a special celebration than these beautiful strawberry crepes? Oh yeah, no, sorry, I already read that. In a blender jar, add the eggs, milk, water, 3 tablespoons melted butter, and flour, and salt, and we're gonna blend it until smooth. Okay, I didn't know we were gonna be using the blender for this, so it's gonna require just a little bit of moving stuff around, but we can do it. I like to do that stuff when we're not shooting, but sometimes things come up. I'm gonna unplug our other thing that I thought we were gonna be doing. All right, so this is our blender jar is what they call it, I guess. And we're gonna add in our eggs. Sorry, I'm not sure what that is. So let's just crack our eggs into this thing. Try not to get any shell in there, but if you do get shell in there, it's completely edible. Okay. Beelzebub gifted. So thanks for gifting Beelzebub to Hans von Sauerkraut. We want 3 eggs. Cracking eggs is probably one of the most basic skills that you're gonna need, not just in the kitchen, but just in life. You know, probably the first thing they teach you when you go to cooking school is if somebody put a gun to your head and said, crack me an egg, you're gonna wanna know how to do it. And you're actually probably going to want to do it better than anybody else. The right response after you've been doing it for a long time is to say, sir, I'm going to crack you an egg, but it's also going to be the best damn egg you've ever had. Okay, so add the eggs. We want a little bit of milk, half a cup of milk. I've got this thing, which is a half a cup. It's some milk. Be careful if you're working with complicated machinery like this. It's very easy to mutilate your hand or something if you go reaching in there. So usually you want to just use a bowl and mix it up because it's a little too dangerous. But I'm going to leave that up to you to decide if you're capable. But if you do hurt yourself, you can always sue the company, which in this case is... Cuisinart. Okay, so 3 tablespoons of melted butter. Boy, I really didn't prepare too much here. Okay, so here's my butter. I don't know if you can see at that view here. Let's put it in a different view here. Every stick of butter has these things on it. I don't know if you can see it, if it's in focus, but it's got 1 tablespoon, 2 tablespoons, 3 tablespoons, whatever. So I'm gonna just cut them according to what it says. So we need, what did it say? 4.5 tablespoons of butter. I mean, that's a lot of butter. But I'm just going to guesstimate here. I want to thank Gaming Matter for resubscribing. Great Gaming Matter 101. Okay, it also says it's supposed to be melted, so I guess I'm going to put that in the microwave. Okay. Put the butter away for now. Putting a lot of shit in here. Okay, yeah, we also want to have some water, half a cup of water. So I'm going to take my half a cup thing that I had earlier. I've got water over here in the fridge. And we want some salt. In terms of salt, it looks like we want half a teaspoon. No problem there. That's a half a teaspoon, and our salt is here. So this is kind of tricky because it's a salt where you have to grind it. So you have to kind of do it. If you had 3 hands, it'd be perfect, but it's kind of impossible when you think about it. If you can, you know what, I'm just gonna put what looks like it's probably a half a teaspoon of salt in there. Because I can't figure out, you know, sometimes some of these things are meant for 2 people. Okay, so we're just going to blend all of this until smooth. I have to get my top for this thing. Thanks, it's Kate X, resubscribed. Got the top here. We're gonna blend until smooth. Move some of this stuff out of the way so you can get a better view of what we're doing here.
Okay.
All right. So this is a standard blender, and you can see it's got all these different things. And just a little trick of the trade. These things all basically do the same thing. They all blend. So you can pick whichever one you want. There's none of them that just are called blend. It's just a lot of synonyms for blend, like mix, you know, puree. I like that one sometimes because it's French. Dr. Blasty Stick just resubscribed. Thanks, Dr. Blasty Stick. You want to do this for probably maybe about a year. Sort of use your judgment on that. Okay, well, I think we've got this. This is going to be called Our Batter. And, I didn't put the butter in. I was supposed to microwave the butter, so... Let's do that now, and then I'm just gonna pour it in there. And then we blend until smooth, which we've done. We pureed it, if you will. By the way, I think I might have missed somebody here. Dr. Blasty Stick and Chris, aka Dark, has subscribed. So thanks, Chris, aka Dark. I don't like to miss those. But sometimes I have to while I'm in the middle of cooking. Do you hear me okay? Check. Hyde White 2 says, the taste won't change with more blending, so it's saved. Yeah, that's the way I look at it. Kairosa says, I think there's an app called Grindr where people can come by and help you with grinding the salt and pepper. Oh, okay. Oh, shit. What was that? Oh, come on. I heard a loud popping noise, and I think the butter exploded or something. I don't know. But anyway, there's our butter. It's mostly melted. Now the microwave has a issue I'll have to attend to. I'm just going to grind it a little bit more. Grinder. Okay, so this is our batter. Our batter is done. I'm going to unplug our blender at this point and plug in our next order of business, which is called the skillet. But let's just sort of put this aside and grab this. Put this somewhere. In a large bowl, which I have, we will be now combining the cream cheese, the confectioner's sugar, lemon juice. I don't know if I have lemon juice now. Vanilla extract I have, and we're gonna beat with an electric mixer until the mixture is smooth, and the whipped cream. We need whipped cream too. I don't know if I have whipped cream. I have something called whipping cream, which I guess is the same thing. Whipped cream sounds like it's already been whipped. Whipping means you're whipping it at the time. Until the mixture is smooth, and then, okay, so let's go ahead and get our cream cheese going. Thanks to the lovely people at Philadelphia Cream Cheese, which are, again, not a sponsor, but if they want to sponsor me, they certainly are able to. All right, so how much cream cheese it says we want. Cream cheese, it says it wants one package. I don't know about a package. I don't know, that seems like a lot. I think I might do half a package. Yeah. I don't know how they know how big my package is. But either way, we're going to use half of it. Okay. So I'm going to put this back in the fridge. And let's move on to our... what does it say here? We want our confectioner's sugar, of which we need... confectioner's sugar, 1 1/4 cups. That's a lot of confectioner's sugar. That's a lot. I think I'm going to do 1 cup because I don't want to go crazy. So, this is the way that you do this. An amateur would probably just take this, scoop it in there, and then you get sugar all over the place. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use my smallest unit, which is the 1/4 cup, which is nice and small so I can get it in there without getting sugar everywhere. But I'm going to use 4 of them. If you use 4 of them, Alexa, how many 1/4 cups makes 1 cup?
1 cup divided by 0.25 cups is 4.
See? So I'm going to use 4 of these guys. And that way it's not going to get messy. Take this out. Cream cheese doesn't want to get out of there. That cream cheese was pretty tasty. I don't know if that was 3 or 4. Was anybody counting? Does anybody know whether I did 3 or 4? Okay. I'm seeing some people say 3, some said 4, some people say 6. Yeah, you guys, you gotta count while you're doing this. Otherwise, you're gonna be all wrong. But I've got an idea. It said 1 1/4 cups. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do 1 more. And if it was 4, then this will be a 1 1/4, which is what we wanted anyway. And if not, it's just going to be 1 1/4 less, but that's okay. But that's a little bit of a lesson about making sure that you count when you're doing this kind of stuff. The kitchen is one of the few places that actually is an exact science. Let's see what our next order of business is here. We've got our... confectioner's sugar, cream cheese, lemon juice, and vanilla extract. I don't know how much vanilla they want. Looks like they want half a teaspoon. It's kind of a lot, but... a little bit of vanilla extract is going to go a long way, but it is delicious, I will say. We also want to grab some of our lemon juice. I don't know that I have lemon juice. Actually... I do have lemon juice, I think, from when we made our souffle. And I remember forgetting that I bought it, so we didn't use it for our souffle, but I think that we have it now. I'm trying to find an expiration date on it. I don't think lemon juice actually has an expiration because it's acidic, so there's generally not a lot of bacteria that's going to live in there. But... let's go ahead and put, we need 1 tablespoon. So I'm gonna grab our tablespoon, which has a lot of cream cheese in it, but that's okay. It's all going down the same place. There's that. And I think that does it. So what we're doing now is we're making our filling. So, in a large bowl, combine cream cheese, confectioner's sugar, lemon juice, vanilla extract. Beat with an electric mixture until smooth. So that's something I'm going to have to... I know I have an electric mixer here. Used this thing in a long time, and I think I actually stopped using it, and I was going to take it back because it's always a problem. But we're going to try to use it again. I have more experience in the kitchen now than I did before when I was doing this, so this goes here. I know that. And there's another one. So I gotta plug this in. I gotta unplug that other thing too. Well, that didn't work. See, that's the thing. This one always comes out. I can tell it's not going in. Does anybody have any experience with these things? Doing now is we're making our filling, and you want to get it nice and smooth. Hamno MC says you have to lube it first. Audrissa, could we have a wellness check on roast beef? Okay, yeah, that's a good idea. We're gonna have to check in with roast beef. Get all the flour parts. Okay, and then this thing just keeps coming out. We have a request to check in on my cat roast beef. Let's see the best way to do that. Okay, he's in the bathroom. So yeah, I think he's doing okay. He's got this place under the sink that he likes to go and hang out. As a matter of fact, maybe I'll leave that door open so we can check on him every now and then.
Okay.
Hope he's okay. It looks like kind of an uncomfortable position to be in. But, all right, well, let's get back into our business here. If you're just joining us, we are making Henry's Delicious Strawberry Crepe. And if you are following along and you've got your ingredients, you should have in front of you some batter in a blender jar, as well as a bunch of eggshells and one of these, and kind of a greenish looking filling fluid. So that's all done. Let me unplug this thing, and I'm going to plug in our other item in a second here. Add the whipped cream to the cream cheese mixture. Again, we don't have whipped cream, we have whipping cream, but I think it's a similar thing. It sounds like it's more a matter of tense. Let's see, somebody's saying something here. M fixed, crazy if even such an experienced professional cook as Henry has to use notes to make the recipe, as newbies have no chance. Yeah, don't feel bad. I use notes all the time. I get a lot of these dishes from the internet. It's not plagiarism if you get it from the internet. You want to make every dish the best that you can, and sometimes you just don't want to miss a beat. But let's see here. Add the whipped cream to the cream cheese mixture. Gently fold in using a large silicone spatula, which I think I have. I have my Witch Please spoon, which is sort of like a spatula, and this is a little premature, but we're going to be using this a lot for the month of October when we have our Halloween dishes. But in terms of cream, we want 1 cup, and we're going to mix that up in there. This is called heavy whipping cream, guys, not whipped cream. Okay, and now we're gonna, what does it say, fold it in or some shit? I don't know what they mean by fold it. You can't fold a liquid. But it says gently fold in using a large silicone spatula. So I think they just mean stir it up. It pretty much just looks like milk. But you want to stir it up so that it's creamy and consistent. Meantime, What the Duck says, I messed up and somehow my cream ended up whipping me. Please help. Yeah, no, I mean, in the kitchen, there's always going to be some kind of danger that you want to look out for. Spelzing, you pour it in. Oh, it went by too fast. Is the Shrek crap, says Zodbane. BZ Casey, Henry, I was kicked out of my local supermarket for complaining to the manager that their vanilla extract didn't make my food that lovely green color. Yeah, now one time I used food coloring instead of vanilla extract, and I think that the reason was that they come in very similar packages, and that's fucked up. They need to stop doing that, because there's people out there. Obviously, I was a little bit inexperienced at the time, but there's a lot of people that are, you know, just trying to learn to cook for the first time or whatever, and they're going to mix up the two, and you don't want to mix those up. Although, food coloring doesn't have any flavor, so it doesn't really matter, and neither does vanilla extract, so you can kind of combine the two, and who knows, maybe it'll give you some kind of a fun color. Okay. Heno MC says, is the green thing frog juice? Yeah, I guess. Yup, Eric has subscribed. So has someone named Anomandarus, Draconic Elf, you many. Hosted my channel with 5 viewers. Thanks, you Nemi. And people are cheering bits and subscribing. Dr. Blasty Stick. Thank you. Thanks very much. All right, this looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and see what our next order of business is here. We're going to heat a heavy medium-sized skillet over a medium heat. Lightly grease the bottom of the pan using a silicone pastry brush and some of the reserved 1.5 tablespoons of butter. Oh yeah, we've still got some butter. So, all right, let's start getting into that now. I'm going to take all the things we don't need, the flour, lemon juice, confectioner's sugar, eggshells, whipping cream. I do need my coffee, however. And we're going to even set that aside. Let's start taking a look at this situation with the skillet. As you can see here, I have a standard issue stainless steel skillet. This thing is a hard worker. They call it the workhorse of the kitchen. It's going to be working harder for you than just about anything else in your kitchen. As you can see, it's got some scars on it, some battle scars, but that's okay. This kitchen is no place for the weak. Okay, so it says that we need to, let's first start this. I'm going to put it on, what did it say, medium? Put it on start. And lightly grease using a silicone pastry brush. I don't have a silicone brush. I believe I have just a regular brush. So I'm going to get our bowl. Use some of this leftover butter here. Start greasing it that way. And I don't know why we're doing this, to be honest with you. We already have butter in it. But maybe they just want to be extra careful. I don't know. Okay. So that's going. And what we're going to do now, when the pan is hot, we're going to scoop a quarter of our crepe batter into the pan and immediately swirl it to create an even layer of batter. Crepes are very thin and the batter will cook fast, so you need to move the pan quickly in order to spread the batter evenly. All right, hold on. This is a lot of stuff. I'm gonna say right off the bat, I don't think I'm necessarily an unintelligent guy, but my brain moves very slowly compared to a lot of people. So that's okay. It just means that I have to read things sometimes a couple of times, and it sounds like this is gonna be time sensitive, where we gotta be fast. So let's take a look. Once the pan is hot, we're going to scoop a quarter of our crepe batter, which is this. I think I'm just going to pour what looks to be a quarter of it. And once we've done that, we're going to immediately swirl it to create an even layer of batter. Crepes are fairly thin and the batter will cook fast, so you need to move the pan quickly in order to spread the batter the batter evenly. So you got to move quickly, guys. All right, so let's go ahead and do this. Let's start by putting what looks to be a quarter of our batter in there. And I need something to stir it with. Oh, shit. God, son of a bitch. I just got batter all over my computer. 2 tablespoons. It says crepes are fairly thin and the batter will cook fast, so you need to move the pan quickly in order to spread the batter evenly. Swirl. Oh, I see what they mean. They mean they want me to swirl the actual pan. That could have been better phrased. But either way, I think this is probably coming out fine. It's definitely cooking quickly. All right, now the question is, what do they want us to do with this? When the crepe looks almost dry on the top and the underside is lightly browned, we're gonna flip it, cook the second side until it's lightly browned, and we're gonna move it to a platter. Okay? So we need a platter. I've got a platter. This thing's very hot, but I want you to see the platter. Okay, so we're gonna flip it. Okay, now it's starting to look a little bit like a real crepe. I can't seem to get this one to be that brownish color, but that's okay. I think I know where they're going with this. The domain GPCE, I'm so glad that Roast Beef loves his chef's hat. Yes, he does. Now he can cook along with you. Yeah, I gotta get him to leave it on for just a little bit more than a few seconds, but I did get a good shot of it. Okay, so this is our first crepe, and this one does not want to get on there. Okay, I think it's going to repeat the process, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so yeah, we're going to do this again. I'm going to get more butter, guys, because I'm starting to think that butter is... what we're doing is we're using the butter to... make it so it doesn't stick, which I get now. Wow, okay. It's very hot. That could have gone better. Okay, so now let's pour more of... I think I'm going to pour a little bit more. Let that cook a little bit. Okay. I have a question. If anybody out there has been paying attention, did we ever use our flour? I had flour out, but I don't remember.
Did we use the flour?
Well, either way, it looks like crap, so we know that we're doing something right. Let's go ahead and flip these. Might need a little bit more time. It's still a little bit runny. I honestly don't know what when we were supposed to put flour in. I think it's flour's a small word, and I think it got buried in the small print. I'm just going to show you guys what I'm looking at here. It's very small print, and it looks like the word flour is just sort of wedged in there, very small, and I didn't use any flour for this. But it looks perfect, so I don't think it really matters. This definitely looks like the crap that they make when you go to like a French restaurant. Let's flip it. Oh, Jesse just gifted 15 subs. Thanks, Jesse. That's very nice of you. I have a lot of thank yous to say because people have been very supportive. And I'm on my way to partner. I have an application in, but I haven't heard anything yet. But hopefully we'll get that going. All right, this looks ready. So I'm going to put this on our platter. This is really jiggly. Kaffee just gifted 5 subs. Thanks, Kaffee. It's so jiggly, it doesn't really want to get out of there. Crepes are very delicate, like a lot of French culinary cuisine. So you have to, you know, you have to be a little nuanced with it. But this is going okay. If anybody wants to see what our final product is going to look like here, it's going to be very nice. But we haven't added the strawberries yet. It looks like we're probably going to put a little bit of garnish on top. I don't know if that's arugula or maybe some iceberg lettuce or something. But anyway, let's get back to our crap. Oh, that's not enough. I thought I was going to be able to make another one, but that's not enough. But we can certainly... Yeah, no, I don't know why I'm bothering with this. This is stupid. Make a tiny mini crap. Like maybe if roast beef wanted to enjoy a strawberry crap. But, yeah, nah. Okay. So, I think that went well. Let's go ahead and turn this off. That thing is broken, so it's hard to take it off. This is very hot. Let's ditch this. And next up, can you hear me okay, by the way? Thumb Power says if you cut the hair around it, it will look like more. Oh, yeah. Hacklin says the green on top is basil. Well, that's good because I do have some basil. I also have some rosemary pricks, so we're gonna do something there. To make the crepe, fill each crepe with about 1/3 of a cup of the cream mixture. Remember that vanilla extract and egg confectioner sugar mixture and about a quarter of a cup of the sliced strawberries. And we're gonna gently wrap the crepe around the filling. So let's see how this goes. We don't really have something necessarily that you can fill necessarily. It's more of a crumbly situation and it's very hot, but we're gonna do the best we can here. I'm gonna take some filling. Cover it up. Put the strawberries on top. Actually, these strawberries should be cut. So I'm just gonna cut these up. I might save this green part. It's almost looking a little Christmassy. Okay. Let's get a little bit more of our filling here. Fold it over best you can. I know this came out a little bit crumbly, but we're still gonna try to do it by the book. Let's do some another one of these sliced strawberries. I think the strawberries are probably gonna be the best part of this. Use more since that crap is much bigger. I think we could even use more. You know, there's a lot of improvisation that happens in the kitchen. And that's kind of what I'm doing now. I'm just, like, for example, I didn't have any idea how many strawberries I was going to use, but I've been doing it long enough that I can kind of figure it out. Okay, I'm going to top all of this with a little bit of more confectioner's sugar. And I think we're just about there. Oh yeah, we want to put some rosemary pricks over top. I still have some rosemary pricks left over from when we did our last dish, which I'm not remembering immediately what it was. I think it was, these are very old actually, I don't know. What can we put on there as a garnish? Maybe a little bit of this. This is just a little lettuce. Most of these green garnishes that you put over top are really just to make it look nicer, but it doesn't necessarily affect the taste. Okay. There we go. Need a sip of coffee after all that. This was a lot of work. Let's take a look at what we're going for here. And what we take a look at our version of it. And I've said this before, you know, don't get discouraged if yours doesn't look exactly like what they're doing on the internet. I mean, this is obviously a photo shoot where they've got, you know, many photographers and people arranging the food, and then it gets photoshopped afterward to make the colors up. Nobody's crepes are gonna look that good, you know? They're gonna more likely come out looking something like this. But they should be delicious. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put them in the refrigerator to chill for a little bit, and then when we're done, hopefully we will be able to enjoy ourselves some nice strawberry crepe. Brian W. Foster just gifted 10 subs. Brian, thank you so much. Brian's been very supportive, and he reminded me that there's a lot of people that I want to thank for the Henry's Kitchen Twitch experience. It takes a village. It's not just me doing all this. I'm going to start with thanking the moderators, Dingo Bop, Fawcan, Dom Beef, Hottest Bear, Do Dingle, Doggoggy, Dr. Flanges, and Backhoos. I also early on met Bumble Vision, who said that Sir Doom turned him on to Henry's Kitchen, and through Bumble Vision, I've met the LGX, and more recently Chase, okay, and also Daisy Blossom. Double-Edged Board just subscribed. Thanks for that. So I've met these people, and then there's also established people like Brian W. Foster, Moon Moon, XQC, Forsen, Emeru, okay, that have just watched the Henry's Kitchen videos on their streams. And I always say that none of these thank you messages would be complete if I didn't thank Nim, because Nim is the one that I started getting all these people on YouTube saying, you know, I saw this on Nim, and then he and I got together and made a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and that's pretty much why I'm here, and I've been really enjoying it. I haven't had this much interaction with other humans in a long time. I also want to thank Quanto. Quanto does technical help for me, and I'm really not good. I mean, look, I'm a cook. That's what I do well. I know how to do it. I've been doing it a long time. It's my area of expertise. I don't know much about the technical stuff, but Quanto came forward, and the first thing that he did was he made these amazing transitions, you know, where suddenly I was able to, you know, do all this cool stuff. So thanks, Quanto, for that. And Quanto, it's Quanto. So yeah, Shane Yes says Quanto MVP. And Shane Yes, thanks a lot. Shane Yes helps a lot. Very active on the Discord and on Reddit. By the way, I'd ask the moderators, if you don't mind, to post the Discord, because we definitely are having a lot of fun there. That's where you can suggest songs, and you can suggest recipes, games, and all that kind of stuff. Speaking of which, I have a couple of song requests that I'm going to get to right now. I often tell people that in the beginning of our streams, I do a sound check, and a lot of times you'll hear me say weird words. Asparagus, which tests the sibilance. Help, which is P. It's testing the P sound and the H at the same time. Help. So don't worry, I'm not sitting here with a gun to my head. It's really just me voluntarily cooking in my kitchen. Help! Okay, so let's see what we've got to work with here. We've got some song requests, starting with one from someone named Elowith, who actually wanted to hear a song called Help by the Beatles. So let's try to do that. Help, I need somebody, help,
not just anybody. Help, you know I need someone. Help. When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way. But now these days are gone and I'm not so self-assured. And now I changed my mind and opened up the door. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate you being around. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me? And now my life has changed in oh so many ways. I never said the independence vanished.
So that one I had a hard time with. If you ever hear a problem with the pitch of my singing versus the guitar, that's because I had a sinus infection. But it certainly doesn't mean that I don't have talent. Okay, so Whiterbite has subscribed. Thank you for that. Standard average. LOL. Gifted a sub to the wizard. These are all terms that I would have no idea what they meant 3 months ago. Brillos, double-edged board, Brian W. Foster, Caffey, and then we're back to where we were. Snorfed. Yup, Eric. I just want to make sure I didn't miss it. Draconic Elf, Umeni, Ch, Dr. Blasty Stick. Okay, so we've got another request for a song here. This one is from Cindy, and it's sort of along the same theme. This is all very depressing stuff, guys. Check. Is supposed to be the background singers when you hear them say he. I'm gonna do one more of these, but we'll see how. I don't know. I'm gonna check on the roast beef cam to make sure everything's going okay over there. Yeah, he's fast asleep, so that's good. All is right with the world when he's fast asleep. I'll poke him a little bit later and make sure he's not passed away here. Okay, it's fare thee well, my old true. Never expect to see you again. Sorry. For I'm bound to ride that northern railroad. Perhaps I'll die on this train.
Perhaps he'll die on this train. That's not really where it ends, but I think that was probably about enough of that. Maybe I'll do a couple of verses of a song that I get requested for a lot by Jose Suicidio. Holy guacamole, holy guacamole, I just got hit by a car. You're the one who pushed me in the street, swept me off my feet, left me in a coma. Making guacamole, mix it in the bowly, I just got hepatitis C. You were standing there with a syringe, how it makes me cringe whenever I'm with you. Key change. Guacamole, mix it in the bowly, I just got shot in the face. And you're the one who had the smoking gun, love is just no fun whenever I'm with you. Officer Stromboli, Captain Guacamole, I just got mauled by a bear. And you were standing there covering me with honey, thought it was so funny, how could you be so cruel? Holy guacamole, holy guacamole, baby, I wouldn't change a thing. 'Cause even though I'm down upon my luck, I don't give a fuck, long as I have.
One other thing I'd like to do today, and that's that there's a new game out there that's been sweeping the nation, and it's called Trombone Champ, and it's a little bit like Guitar Hero, and I was playing it, and I actually think this is one of the games that I'm pretty good at, actually. So I'll see if you guys can be the judges on that. Art Official just subscribe, so thank you for that. All right, so here's this game. Let's see, I'm going to pull it up so that you can see it. Always a little bit of a technical thing here, but okay, we're going to start from scratch. I want to first ask you guys, do you hear me and do you hear the game okay? No, I don't think you hear the game yet. I'm going to have to... You hear the game now? Okay. Game is a little bit quiet. Okay, how do we do that now?
But until that day comes,
okay, did we fix that?
You must toot. Toot your trombone, brave soul, and you may yet become the trombone champ.
Okay, but you can hear me okay, right? Is that correct? Check. Help. Okay, so I'm having a problem. Okay, desktop audio is too loud. Thanks, Quanto. We're gonna turn that way down then. How's that? Is that getting good? Okay, better. Fixed. Thanks, Doxino. And thanks, Quanto. All right. Here we go. We're going to play this game. And basically what you're doing is, if you've ever played Guitar Hero, it's a very similar situation. Pap1 says, turn the game down. I can't tell if you guys are fucking with me or not, but... maybe I'll turn it up a little bit. Okay. Okay. Astral Unicorn says it's intended fucking with you. All right, sounds great. Perfect. Okay, here we go. We're just gonna play. You pick a character. There is a guy with white hair, and apparently my hair is white now, so whatever. This is the warm-up. I'm going to be looking at you guys to make sure that everything's working okay here. So you move the mouse forward and back, and then you press the left mouse button to toot. And that's it. If you play well, then there's all kinds of... stuff. You have the breath meter, so you can't just leave it on the whole time. You have to. So, all right, let's go ahead and do this. You got to be able to hear it though, because if you don't hear it, then the whole thing is just a waste. So let me know. Oh, so this is just warming up. Perfect, it says. I actually did play the trombone when I was in sixth grade. But I found the band kids to be, have a little too much, I don't know what you would call it, edge for me or something. So I wound up not ever doing any other extracurricular activities. Okay, so we're all warmed up here. You can hear that okay. Blurry Little Quest says, from an expert tromboner. Okay, what is it? Death by Fugu says, I learned on the nasty trombone, or the rusty trombone. Do you think I'll be able to adapt to this type? And then Dusty Nabel made a similar comment about the rusty trombone. I'm not familiar. Hamo MC, I don't hear it because I don't have ears. Okay, well, that I can't help with. Okay. Let's. What we're going to do now is we're going to select a track, but... I'm going to put the mouse up on a shoebox because... I don't want to be ergonomically incorrect. I also want to be able to see this a little better. You have to have hand-eye coordination. Let's see. Zodbane says, you can use any key on the keyboard, like space, instead of clicking the mouse, so you don't have to click and move with the same hand. Ooh. Really? Problem is I want to do them both on my right hand. I'm going to try to do this again the way I did it, and we'll see. All right, let's pick a song that's basically, that doesn't look very hard. Take me out of the ball. Okay, Auld Lang Syne, that's not a bad one. Shouldn't be too hard. There are between 2 and 4 spiders living inside the average trombone. I did not know that. It's freaky. Wow, fast. I didn't know it was going to be that fast. Shit. I've never heard this song done this. And it's going on for like 10 minutes. This is problematic. What is it, 10 minutes long? All right, we gotta do a slower one. I don't know if there's difficulty levels, but that was ridiculous. Yeah, Quanto says that's a weird cover of a Jose Suicidio song. Jose Suicidio did a version of that song. It's available on iTunes or Spotify or wherever you listen to music. Spellsling says, "Oh, Canada is a slow in honor of making crap today." Oh, that's great. Was "Oh, Canada" in there? Oh, it is. Okay, this is the Canadian national anthem. And today we did make crap, which is a French Canadian dish. And apparently this is a little slower, so let's do it. The first trombone was invented in 20 million BC. That's pretty cool. Did not know that. Try to sing along to it because they have the words on the bottom, but that's just too much for my brain to be able to do. I didn't think that went so bad. I got a C. C's not bad. Let's see if we can get a B on one of these. Lars24 says, "Wow, this is incredible, Henry. Thanks for respecting my country, Canada." Okay, thanks, Lars. I think it's a little bit reminiscent of the rendition of the Star Spangled Banner that Roseanne did once way back when. And I think you can see that on YouTube. Newt34 says, "Henry,
what was the song from the other night where you talked about getting a letter in the mail? Oh yeah, that song is called Letter in the Mail. And that's available wherever you stream music as well. Just Letter in the Mail, Henry Phillips. I might be able to, maybe I can close today with that one, but I always mess up the lyrics. Okay, let's see what else we got here. Beethoven's Fifth. Oh, Blue Danube, that's not a very fast one. That one should be good. This was from 2001, A Space Odyssey. If you placed all of the trombones on Earth end to end, they would wrap around the solar system four times. That's incredible. I'm gonna have to try this Zyphon's what did I get here? F? No. Oh, that sucked. All right, maybe we'll try one more. Kaffee says, the skill and courage displayed is nothing short of breathtaking. Thanks, Kaffee. You know, I mean, it's like anything. I guess that trombone playing is something that you have to sort of practice. I'm going to do one more. I'm going to go out with a bang. Uh-oh. I think I heard roast beef. I'm gonna do Beethoven's Fifth, and then we're at it. We're done with this game. We're gonna eat some crepes. I'm gonna close with the song. Okay, here. There are more trombones on Earth than there are humans. That's probably about 8 billion, I think, at this point. Thank you. This is probably my favorite piece. I just heard somebody banging on my floor. I'm getting carpal tunnel. Okay, there we go. So that is the game. Sorry. Didn't do too well. I thought I was going to do better since I'm a musician, but I guess not. How do I get out of here now? Boy, I don't even know how to get out. But we did it. Okay. It's time to eat some crap. Shit. Okay, so what happened here is that I guess that I had my plate up against the door, and so when I opened the door, the whole damn thing fell. And now I don't even know what I did with it. Yeah, see. This really sucks. I don't think we're going to be eating crap today. And I'm not sure what we can do about it. I don't even know what I did with the plate at this point.
Okay.
Thanks, Itdobe Dot. This is very embarrassing, and I'm going to have a lot, to clean up, so, I don't really know what to do here. I'm going to cut to, we'll cut to, roast beef. Who's now done with his nap, yeah, this, you know what, I've got this stuff, which, it's not that great, actually. I don't know what I did with my, plate there. Let me try to find it. Okay. I guess I can salvage just a little tiny bit of crap that didn't fall on the floor. And I'll try to eat that. Yeah, you know, I'm gonna have to, I guess, clean all this shit up. Just show you once again what happened here. It fell down from over here onto all this stuff.
So that's not going to be a fun cleanup time for me. So once again, if you're just joining us, we were attempting to make crap, which was supposed to look like this, and it did. To be fair, it did look like this, but then when I was pulling it out of the refrigerator after being chilled, I spilled it on the floor, which is very unfortunate. I tasted a little bit of it. It seemed like it was going to be good. I still do have the filling. Also, it hit my foot when it came down, and my foot's starting to hurt. So I'm going to go ahead and close out here with a song. I think it's time. But I want to mention to everybody that three times a week I stream. Two of those times I'm cooking. That's Sundays and Wednesdays. But then Thursday nights at 9 p.m. I just do, just for me, I do some songs and some games. And the cooking is a real pain in the ass, and there's a lot of cleanup involved. So in this case... I don't have to worry about that. Nova Miro. And by the way, I want to thank everyone so much. My first sponsored campaign was this month, and Factor 75, it's boxed meals. I think the link is still there. But I had like 15 of you guys sign up for it, and that's great because not only you get a discount and it's boxed meals, so you don't have to be cooking in your kitchen. You just put them in the microwave for 2 minutes and you're eating good food. But also, it lets people know that Henry's Kitchen is, that it came from Henry's Kitchen, and that helps me. So thank you for that. All right. Well, I'm going to close out with a song here. Oh, it looks like roast beef has emerged here and wants to join us. Not exactly sure what's going on with him. But let's take a look at the roast beef cam now.
Delicious.
Wow, Ted the Zodiac Cruz just donated $5. I think that's very cool, and thank you very much for doing that, Ted. I'm probably gonna be using that toward getting ingredients to replenish my crap, because I really did want to make that, and I was looking forward to eating it, and it's very disappointing. The kitchen is a place for a lot of disappointments. That's all I'm gonna say. Let's see if I can get this song right.
Delicious.
Wow, Leo Stockholm donated $5 as well. Thank you very much, Leo Stockholm.
Oh, hi.
And wow, CW Hazoo gifted 10 subs. Thanks, CW Hazoo.
Okay.
Thanks, CJNJ193.
Delicious.
Wow. You're retarded donated $5. Thank you so much, Yuri.
I just got a letter in the mail saying that I failed to pay my credit card in time, and that's a $40 fine, which would have been okay, except for that it caused me to exceed my credit line, and that's another $40 fine. Then I got another piece of mail. This one said the balance due was drawn from my checking account, which caused a bunch of checks to bounce, which would have been okay, except the fact that one of those checks was to the DMV for my registration fee. So the next day I was on my way to work, and I couldn't find my car. It wasn't where I parked it just the day before. And then I got another piece of mail. This one said the registration tags were out of date, so they had to tow my car away, which wasn't quite okay. I called them to explain, and when I finally got through, they just made me wait on hold.
Delicious.
After 40 minutes, I hung up because I had to go to work. But then I realized, if I don't have a car, then how the fuck would I get to work? So I got fired from my job. So here I am, living in a box underneath a bridge in this quiet little town. And I take a look around, things are quite okay. I don't get any bills, and the best part of it is that I don't get any mail.
Well, that's a true story. Thanks, everyone. My cat Roast Beef is alive and well. This isn't a very flattering angle of him, but here, maybe I'll turn it around a little bit. Maybe a little more like that. But I want to say a huge thanks to everybody for joining me, some people donating. Obama donated as well. A lot of people donated. People subscribed. MC Ride One, you get no mail, but do you get any bitches?
Okay.
Reptarsonist just prescribed. Subscribed. Sorry, I'm still new to the technology. All right. Thank you guys very much. Thanks to all the moderators. Thanks again to Quanto for the technical help there. And just overall, and thanks to Daniel and Raven for the lovely chef's hat for Roast Beef. Once more, I'm going to show that. And they are with the domain GPCE podcast. So thanks very much again for that. And just overall, I want to thank everybody because... there's not a whole lot of awesome things going on in my life, but this is something I always look forward to, and I just really appreciate it. I'm going to clean up this stuff, because cleanup is a very important part of working in the kitchen. If you spill whatever it is that you're trying to make, you want to make sure that you you clean it up, because nobody else is going to do it for you. So thanks, everyone, and I hope you have a fantastic rest of your Sunday or Sunday evening, as the case may be, and just hope that you have a great week. From all of us here at Henry's Kitchen, it's basically just me and my cat, we want to wish you a happy week.